Welcome to the GNL show.
This week's cast involves me. I'm sure you all know me. Captain Hook 5150, also known as Tim.
Hey.
Greg C96, Spam Johnson, and our two special guests, Gordo and Kevin.
From forth the questionable minds of Greg and Liberty, we bring you the GNL show.
Hello.
All right.
That was just such a dead silence. Like, I was just like, all right, who's going to say something? But nope, we're all just going to remain quiet.
Yeah. All right, so you guys know Gordo. He's been a couple of these now. But, Kevin, we got to get your geek credit up first before the podcast can start.
Cool.
So tell us about yourself.
Let's see. I work at That's Entertainment Pop Culture Emporium right in beautiful Worcester.
Emporium?
Emporium.
Oh.
No.
Got to be excited for a second.
I know. It's not as exciting as it sounds.
What? It's being just in a porno or?
Yeah, you know. That's
I'm sorry.
Stuff,
continue.
Right? It's okay. I don't know. I read comics. I watch movies. I play video games.
Yeah, that's about
what do you want to know?
We do, so.
Yeah.
What is your favorite animal?
This is important.
Exotic animal. It can't be like a dog or anything, like, because everybody loves dogs or cats
or
something.
If you don't love dogs, then I don't know. Penguins.
That's fair.
Yeah, all about penguins. Dress to impress.
Yeah.
Live in all climates.
I'm more of a flamingo guy.
Ooh, flamingos are cool.
Yeah.
Really good
if
balance.
If you were a tree, what tree would you be?
All right, let's get
no,
started.
This is really important, Greg. What tree would you be, Kevin?
Oh, I would have to be... I'm just going to go with cedar.
I can respect that.
Cedar always smells pretty nice. I don't know.
That's true, it does.
Yeah.
Which kind of drug would you do on any game? I'm more of a cocaine guy. I'm just going to say.
Yeah.
Actually, I have a great story.
Not diet cocaine, though.
Yeah, not diet cocaine.
Great story. So.
What about cocaine zero? That's got no sugar, right?
Cocaine
I like the
clear.
Cherry kind. The cherry kind is my situation.
Oh, dude, cocaine clear is some old school, Tim. You're showing
That's,
your old
yes.
man big box.
I am. Yes, I'm showing my age there.
All right. So let's get into it with a disclosure. This is, well, actually two things. One, this is, I think, officially the record attendance for the GNL show. The only one that might have surpassed it is the one we did live during Extra Life. I haven't looked at the numbers, though, but I think there was like either 6 or 7 in that one. I'm not entirely sure. But yeah, so it could be the record for GNL show hosts, but also, this is another record, because this is the first GNL show that there's literally been no preparation for whatsoever.
True.
I mean, we've had close calls where there weren't any preparation, but this
one we don't have. I at least got some topics together at the last minute. I just got out of work like 5 minutes ago, so.
Not literally.
I'm just a procrastinator. I didn't make much attempt on the whole finding
thing. I actually literally got home 15 minutes ago.
That's literal, yes.
So, yeah. We're going
to jump into the topic.
I agree. Who has one?
Oh, well, I think we were going to be talking about old shows. Just, like, shows in general. Like, probably, like, even older shows would be better. Because maybe I didn't read this. I don't know. Maybe I'm on cocaine or something.
Zero.
That's a whole cocaine. Yeah, cocaine zero.
The clear stuff.
Zero brain cells will be lost. I think isn't Nickelodeon now having its own channel to 90s or like it's having its own time frame for like 90 shows again?
Yes, and I believe it's coming as a YouTube channel.
Oh, is it?
That's what I was told. I could be
wrong.
Well,
but you probably
have
to pay for all
though.
That though. Yeah, if it's YouTube, you're going to have to pay for it. That's the thing. But, like, you know, that's quality television. Like, Keenan Kel, you know, which
they're really
going to
bring back
recently.
Hmm? I think they're going to bring back, like, all of it. Anything that was, like, from the 90s, whether it was cartoon. They're going to do, like, Salute Your Shorts, Hey Dude, Clarissa Explains It All. You know, just
Clarissa Explains It All was one of my favorite shows.
I've heard I heard a few shows are coming back. Like, though, they're trying to do something. Because I know they brought Fairly Odd Parents back from the dead. Because that got canceled a couple times.
Yeah, but it wasn't canceled for very long ever. And it was always brought back.
Yeah, but I'm just saying, like, it's one of those situations where it's going to be... I think Nickelodeon realizes how big some of these properties are, and that a lot of this generation of 90s kids really enjoy that kind of shit. And I think they're trying to get a lot of demographics back now, because they have... it's something after, like, there's Teen Nick, there's the other thing, there's that, like, one for, like, Dora the Explorer, shit like that.
Geriatric Nick?
Sure. I don't know.
God damn it.
I don't know what he just said, but I'll just go with it.
Yeah, they got rid of Nick at Night.
Oh, did they? That's what it was. Yeah. There's Nick at Night.
Yeah.
They got rid of that?
I think Teen Nick still exists, but Nick at Night is gone.
I know Teen Nick.
Jailbait Nick.
It's actually Jailbait Tom. Get it right. That's good for Poon.
See... We've had this discussion before with the people where that originally came from, and we decided that saying that in public is not really acceptable.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. It's not. It's not at all.
Yeah, no. It's really... No. It's,
why I kind of stopped talking about making a shirt for it.
No, we need shirts for it, though.
Yeah. Anyways, continue, though, now that I've derailed this enough. But yeah, so Teen Nick is gone. No, Teen Nick still exists, but Nick at Night is gone.
I think Teen Nick still exists because that's one of the biggest things. Because they're not going to keep that, like, Dora the Explorer crap sitting there.
Degrassi, man.
Oh, yeah. Can't forget about Canadian melodrama.
But that's where Drake started from the bottom.
Now he's here.
That's how it goes. Oh, I got the lyrics wrong.
We need
to get
Drake on the next one so we can actually say "and now he's here."
All right, let's reach out. Let's go. Hey, want to come to a podcast of like
everyone tweet at Drake.
Listen, Drake, we don't want to talk about your music. We just want to talk about
Degrassi.
When you were going out. Yeah, when you were on Degrassi and you were going out with Ashley or whatever her name was.
I think it was Ashley.
I feel like it was Ashley.
I think so. Yeah, like, how was it dating Ashley on TV? Because obviously not in real life, because you were an awkward kid back then. But
Right.
Did she suck your dick is what the question we should be asking here is. We just look at him and like, hey.
Okay, we should probably, like, not derail.
I love how Griffin is the one trying to keep it on track for once.
Yeah, like, it's long gone. Like,
No. Griffin is usually the cause of derailment.
Oh, really? What?
Yeah. Actually, between you and Liberty.
Yeah.
I don't remember that.
R.I.P. Liberty. He didn't die, he just retired.
Yeah, we need to hold a trial for his retirement. Basically, we're saying he gets nothing of Big Box. And he's saying he gets it all.
We've also had this discussion where he thought that he was the... What? How did he phrase it?
Creator.
He was one of the main creators of Big Box.
No, he was the creator.
Oh, the creator of Big Box. Right. Yes. Right. I was gonna try and censor myself because if he watched this video, then he might get a little mad about it. But then I remembered
he doesn't watch us.
He doesn't watch our videos.
He doesn't watch his own creation. What's up with that? Sorry.
No, that's fair. But yeah, Degrassi. Like,
That is like one of the worst. Not the worst, but one of my least favorite shows. Like, there were much better shows that like I'd prefer to watch. Like, the people always skip over the fact that Kids Next Door was
an
older show.
Oh yeah,
that was my childhood.
Totally like, agree.
So,
Degrassi was kind of like a. Daytime soap opera, but for kids. So, like, if people watch soap operas, I totally get it, because I watch Degrassi, but I'll totally admit, every time, terrible show.
Yeah, just an old one that people like being sentimental about.
Yeah, but Kids Next Door, that was prime stuff.
Yeah. So back in third grade, I think it was yeah, it was probably third grade. And this is just something that hasn't, I don't think, ever been brought up since it's happened. Where when I was little, I tried to start my own Kids Next Door, thinking it was like a legitimate thing, like you could really set this thing up. People, I don't know what it is about me. I'm able to convince people to do shit, and it's just like, because it's like a, these far, they completely far and away, these weirdly terrible ideas that will never ever exist. But people are like, that's a great idea. Because it's just like, either you bring up something that's either really, really cool, or it's just like, this isn't going to happen. But let's just be sympathetic.
Where was your base going to be?
See, I thought he said douche it.
No.
My bad.
So I ate an apple. I took the seed, planted it in my backyard, and was like, I'm going to come out here and water every day till it becomes a big, huge house or a big tree. And I was like, I'm going to build like a pathway to my roof, and we're going to build a tower. Yeah, I didn't even make the attempt.
So was it going to get super awkward when you realize your dad was the original?
Oh, that would have been really weird. That I remember that movie, too. That
That was great.
Finish it, like that was the ending of the series, I believe, and that was like to a degree, it was like it was very emotional ending because it was like as a kid you're like this is my favorite show, but you didn't think I don't think people got it was really ending until it was like over, like so it was weird. It was a weird. It was a good ending, but it was very weird to end it the way they did. I don't know.
It was a great ending. Very, yeah.
it had like a definitive ending. I don't think I've ever seen that.
It was a movie.
Yeah, it was
like a full feature-length film.
Yeah.
Oh, dang.
It was released in movie theaters.
Yeah.
No, it wasn't. Was it really? I think it was only on Cartoon Network.
Nope,
they weren't
it was released in theaters.
It was a movie. I'm 90% sure it was in theaters.
I want to look this up.
I'm 100% sure.
I remember this. Dang. It was Code Zero or something.
Number Zero.
Number Zero, thank you.
Code Name Kids Next Door, Number Zero, because his dad was Number Zero, because, you know, he was Number One. He was one.
Is it Operation Zero?
Maybe.
That's what it was.
I think it could be that.
And I don't remember how it played out, though. Because I'm just trying to remember. I don't know. I don't remember how it... I remember him just finding out that Number Zero was his dad, but it was like everyone...
Well, his dad helped him save everything, and then they had to erase his dad's memory. That's what happened.
That's pretty heavy.
Yeah, it was definitely very heavy for a kid's show.
Another great kid's show was Ed, Edd n Eddy.
Ed, Edd n Eddy. Doo.
No, unlike Kids Next Door, this one I didn't get emotionally attached to, per se, but it was still, like, it was still a core part of my childhood because I would always try and pull, like, silly scams and sell, like, pencils for
a
quarter or...
So...
To pay for school lunch.
So I just want to but the last ever episode was Operation Interviews when they show the live action like that. Like it shows the episode like the cartoon episode, but outside it shows like them all grown up and like it was like when Number One left to go to the moon base or some like other place where the kids from another planet needed him most or something.
Oh, I'm gonna have to like look this up then.
I remember that episode very well. That was when they ended it. I had my episodes mixed up.
I don't remember that at all.
I remember that, like, I don't remember it very well, but I remember, like, being on the bus and watching it over and over and over. Like, it was just this repeated episode for me. It was kind of like National Treasure for me.
Was it the short bus, Dave?
No, it was a long
bus. Wait, hold on. Did you just say it was kind of like National Treasure?
For me, it was like National Treasure where I keep watching it over and over and over again. Every time I get a chance,
Kids Next Door to National Treasure.
Because they're both National Treasures. They both have these people in them that are number.
It.
Yeah, there's a comparison somewhere. Don't fuck you, Sam.
Out of all of the possible things that you could have come up with as a comparison,
well, I'm
National
just
Treasure.
I'm just basing it off like of a movie I would watch on my little iPod Nano way back in the day on the bus, just over.
Why would you watch a movie on your Nano?
God, I don't know.
That is the issue here.
I don't care. It was I don't know.
Sure.
So like I don't know. I always like I didn't really listen to music back then. I always watched like I was more into movies than TV.
You know what my cartoon of my childhood was? I think this is like later on too. Because when I was like super young, I used to watch like old school cartoons with my like my dad. But like the first cartoon that I really remember getting super into would have to be Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends.
Yep. That was a good one. That was a really good one.
Okay, so I really like sentimental over Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends. And so recently I just like got back in like the groove of watching it, and I was reading up on it, and just I was reading some things that just completely blew my mind. Like, I guess this is kind of a spoiler, maybe, depending on how you look at it, but...
No, it happened 10 years ago. That's like 3 decades in internet years.
It also might just be a fan theory, but...
Probably.
People... Well, it is a fan theory, I guess, because it hasn't been confirmed, but... People believe that, Madame Foster, had another imaginary friend besides... I'm forgetting his name. I'm a horrible person.
Oh, shoot. Who was Madame Foster's imaginary friend? I forget that now.
It was the rabbit.
The rabbit dude.
Yeah, but what was his name?
Quick, look it up.
Oh, Miss... Yes.
Yeah,
I remember
okay.
now. I can't think of the name, though.
Yeah.
Well, the theory goes along the lines of Frankie also was an imaginary friend. Because... She is always depicted in the same clothes as Madame Foster. She, even though she's considered an adult, she always stays at the foster home. She doesn't really have many friends or many interactions besides with people who are imaginary in the foster home. So it was just like a mind-boggling thing for me when I realized that.
Holy cow. That's mildly insane.
Yeah.
I didn't know we could go so deep into cartoons, man.
Cartoons are deep.
How about Rugrats?
Cartoons were real deep.
You know that deep fan theory? Holy crap.
No.
Oh, is it it's the one that goes
like...
The one
that basically like all the babies are dead. And
except for Angelica.
Angelica's like the only one alive, and Chucky was... Tommy was a stillborn.
No, it was Angelica and then that other... The black girl. I guess it was like her, I think, or something.
Yeah, Angelica's friend there. But basically, like, Tommy was, like, a stillborn. I don't remember what the thing with Chucky was.
He was
in a car accident.
Yeah, something like that. The twins, Phil and Lil, like, they died during it was just one baby that died during childbirth, but Angelica made them twins because she didn't know the gender.
It's
yeah,
one
weird,
didn't
weird
Chucky,
theories behind that.
Yeah,
didn't
man.
Chucky die with...
And it, his mom in a car accident or something?
Yeah.
I don't remember.
And Eddie had a dark one, too.
I haven't seen that one.
That was like all the kids in the... it's like the typical... the same ones all the time. Because since you never saw really saw the parents, like everyone's like, oh, the kids are dead or something. So all the kids in the cul-de-sac are dead, but they like all died really... It's really fucked up. Like, I don't know. And then there's like... I think only one of them lived or something. I don't know. Okay. Or Jimmy was the newest one in the cul-de-sac or something. I don't know.
Plank was the only one that was really alive.
Yeah. He's just sitting in therapy with Johnny, kind of explaining everything out. Except Johnny's now, Johnny 2x4 is the Plank. And so then his parents, you find out Plank's parents are retarded. That's what you find out.
That would explain the eyes.
Yeah. In the mouth. The lack of mouth.
You know what my favorite TV show, though, I have to say is? Not a cartoon. The show that I binge watched before that was a term. Have to be that 70s show.
Oh.
I think it's a good show. I think it has its high and lows. I think we talked about this last week.
We talked about it for a short period of time. I don't remember if it was on the podcast or not.
Yeah, I think it was on. I don't know if you were recording the podcast, but
I think it was off at that point.
It was during the same session, but it might have been afterwards when we had the idea to do this. But I don't remember if that was part of the thing, because honestly, I haven't edited last week's yet. It's going on today, so
I got a
question. That really shouldn't
you guys.
Surprise anybody.
Nope.
Wait, Kevin's got a question.
I get a question because we all know that 70s show. Does anyone remember that 80s show?
Yes.
I remember this. I didn't see.
No.
I've seen like barely an episode.
Pilot episode with Flock of Seagulls for the backing track. Jesus Christ.
Oh yeah, and what's his name from? It's Always Sunny was like the main character. Not Mac, not Charlie. Why can't I think of his name?
I can't think of the name either. But nope, I did, because I as soon as I heard that 80s show was a thing, I was like, this is going to be great, but it sucked.
Yeah, it was downright terrible.
I don't even
terrible.
Think it made it past a season. I don't even think it finished a season.
I don't think so either. But
I think they cut
in
it off
no way
like the
could
third episode.
Compare to...
not at all.
What does Wikipedia say? 13 episodes.
That's, and it was Glenn Howerton.
More than I gave it credit for.
Yeah, yeah. But Glenn Howerton, clearly that 70s show is far superior.
That show will literally be timeless.
It's going to be always funny.
Yeah, I think it was just because the 70s were just such a great period of time and all this stuff happened that it made sense for them to do it. The 80s were just like, it's the 80s. Like, there's music. Like, you know, like, good enough.
Recapture that lightning in a bottle. But
yeah,
I don't know.
Why don't you just? They should have waited till like the 2000s. Shit's going down now. You know.
No, because that will literally just be filled with racism and.
Exactly. That was why it would be so good. Like, I would love that.
Have you seen what's going on in frickin'? Where is it? I'm just an idiot right now. Is it Chicago?
I don't care.
Philadelphia. Where's the place that's like riots constantly right now?
Probably no, not
Baltimore. It's not Chicago.
Baltimore.
Baltimore.
Yeah, Chicago.
That's like that was
out my area, man. Come on.
Hey, I mean, that was Baltimore. Close enough, right? They both start with B and end with Baltimore, except for Chicago.
Chicago doesn't. No. It's not Detroit. Come on.
Oh, Tim's wrecking on Detroit.
Yeah.
Back. Let's go back to lighter things, TV shows.
But yeah.
Speaking of good TV shows that we all binge watch, Survivor was on last night, and I binge watch every single episode leading up to the premiere. It's depressing.
Okay.
Actually, you know what's what? Cool? I've been binge watching Dual Survival.
Oh, fuck off! Get out.
What's such a
kicked off your own?
What's that?
It's a pussy show. That's what it is. It's like two people going like, "Oh, I'm gonna survive out here." It's like, but there's no real premise. It's just them, unless it's besides them like sitting around a fucking fire jerking off. Where it's like Survivor's like it's cutthroat and people.
Okay,
going
here's
out
the
and,
thing
like,
though. I didn't say Dual Survival was a good show about all like. Oh. I didn't say it, no. Let me rephrase that. I think it is a good show. It's an entertaining show though. It's not. I'm not trying to say it's anywhere near the realm of Survivor. Except for the fact that it sort of deals with survival in a bad situation. It's still
is that
a good
like
show.
Naked and Afraid?
It's a good
I
band.
Think Naked and Afraid, I believe, was based from Dual Survival, sort of.
I would rather watch Naked and Afraid just because you see blurred out jugs, and that's the closest thing I'll ever get besides, like, looking at porn. Because, I'm afraid of getting virus on my computer. Simple as that. Like,
Just get a Mac, bro.
Yeah, but then it has, like, a built-in camera. You don't know who's watching. So while you're doing your thing, like, these pop-ups come up or whatever. And people,
put
like,
a Band-Aid
watch this guy.
Over it. People do that.
Just put your thumbs over the camera.
People actually do that.
Are you ashamed?
I like how Greg's saying people put Band-Aids over that. Greg, do you put a Band-Aid over your
computer? I'm not ashamed. But anyways.
Wait.
He doesn't care who's watching.
But anyway, no, like, I've seen people putting their computers in. And they have a Band-Aid chilling over the webcam. And I'm just like, what the hell is that?
That's the great.
People can't watch them.
So people don't see me when I don't want to be seen.
Yeah, man.
I don't think people want to see you as a thing. That's the backup to that, or the comeback.
Oh, snap.
Hey, yo.
Yeah, but Survivor's getting hot and heavy now. That's the best way to put it. Getting crazy.
Is that guy from Massachusetts doing good?
I think he's going to win, and yes, because I went to a viewing party, and I mentioned this, I think, last time. Went to a viewing party. This guy is, like, a firecracker. Like, he was just going around, like, having a great time. And the way you got this vibe of, like, he kind of won. Like, he obviously didn't say anything, but it was just, like, you felt this vibe of he won. Like, or he knew he got far, you know?
Oh, that's true, because the viewing party, all of this has already happened.
Yes.
That's
all
right.
Are they like legally not allowed to release?
Yeah, they're CBS all under NDA.
Oh yeah, CBS has like the contract is just so tight that they basically have your balls in a vice grip.
Huge NDA. Yeah. I frankly think if you're not at a public, like a PR event, and you even mention Survivor, they can sue you for it. Like, that's how tight it is.
Well, for contestants, like, you can tell people in your family of what happened. So they can go, like, oh, I got voted out, like, second. They can't turn around to someone like me, who's a random fucking stranger, and say, I won this game. But he had said something to me, which, not, like, a big deal. But he's like, this season's going to be amazing. He's like, that's all he said to me, and he walked away. After we got a picture and everything. And he just, because he got pulled away by a bunch of people. And just, like, watching him go through the... Because, you know, obviously, I'm very observant of my surroundings, you know. And I'm watching this guy just going around like crazy and just taking shots and, like, freaking... It was awesome. Like, you just got a feeling he won. Like, or something. He got far.
He didn't say anything,
but he just got this feeling.
Oh, and speaking of TV shows, the TV show I was going to be on, I was not able to make the contractual obligation, so that's not going to be a thing. I don't know if I've talked about this at all, actually.
I never knew this.
Crap. That's
Is it that nerd show?
Me. Kinda, sort of. Intel's Next Greatest Maker.
Oh.
But it required me to be available for like 180 days for production of the show, and I just can't do that.
That's pretty crazy.
I cannot do that. No way. But I'm taking the product idea that I created for that show and actually trying to pursue it as an individual product.
You gonna go to the Shark Tank with it?
The Shark Tank, yeah. I'll need just as much time to be on that show.
Dude, and then they'll just steal all your money. Mm-hmm.
Exactly. We'll give you $20 at 5,000% interest.
What is this, Pawn Stars?
I don't know.
Yes.
That's a cool artifact, man, from like the Civil War, and it's got a lot of historical value, and it's pretty rare. I'll give you $20.
So. I looked up the show that you mentioned, Greg. The guy who started this show, or like the whatever the working title, it's America's Greatest Makers or whatever.
Yeah, the Intel the guy, sponsored thing.
Yeah. The guy who's producing this show produces Survivor or created Survivor.
Huh.
Yeah. Which he owns like a ton of like different he's a mega producer basically is what they call
no,
him. He's
yeah.
He has like he made like the Bible show. He made the Bible.
He is the Bible. Jesus.
Bible show.
He looks like it right now. Yeah.
He's about due for another book soon.
Yeah.
The New Testament. This is where shit hits
the Book
the
of
fan.
Mormon. Well, we found it in New York.
This is where shit hits the fan again.
Bible 2, Bible harder.
The Bibling.
Ooh, that's way better.
That's a much better name.
Yeah.
The Bibling.
Is it a gold cover? Gold encrusted cover?
We've gotten off topic a little bit.
Sure, it's still entertaining.
The original topic was old TV shows.
Well, the Bible's old.
TV shows.
We're not
but
totally
it is
old.
I guess so.
There's a whole channel devoted to it.
It's like the 6 degrees of Kevin Bacon. We can relate it.
Bacon. Somehow.
We can do this.
Speaking
Jesus
of
Jesus showed
chewing.
Up on cooking shows. That has to do with bacon. I don't know.
Speaking of doing.
No!
Miley Cyrus will be doing the hosting gig for SNL 41 Episode 1. See, Greg? People can
I could go either way.
Segues.
Other than me can do segues, you mean?
Yeah. Other
I
than
on fire.
I think you just have a bunch of like... That was a bunch of luck.
I think it was.
That entire show literally just segued.
After segue, after segue, after segue. And the funny thing is, I picked all random articles. And it just worked.
So do people even... Because SNL is a show... I mean, I watch SNL because I'm a sketch comedy kind of guy. But, like, I don't know. I feel like it's getting there. It's at season 41. It's getting there. How much longer can they do this shit?
Getting there, like it's getting kind of old, or they're still keeping it fresh.
It's getting up there like in the age kind of bracket of shows, but also just like, it seems material is just being recycled, so it's got to be over soon.
Well, I mean, at a point, what are comedians going to talk about? Like, it's the same type of thing. You're gonna get to a point where every deep topic worth, you know, just comedy in general, every topic worth making a joke about is eventually going to be used to the point that it shouldn't be used ever again.
Well, I mean, right. I don't know.
There's a couple comedians that were able to fight that. I mean, I think mainly of, like, Richard Pryor, George Carlin, Louis C.K. Yeah. The comedian, like, they were able to get very deep. And
Sam Kinison, rip.
Yeah, Sam Kinison, too. But yeah,
George Carlin.
Yeah, they were...
Carlin always had pretty fresh stuff.
Oh, yeah, because he talked about this in an interview once. He was like, you know, at first, when I was a comedian, I sucked.
That's with any comedian. Like, any star
like,
comedian.
Eventually, I realized I can't just keep using the same recycled material. It's not funny anymore. So what I devoted to do is every year, I would throw out my old material. And where do you go from there? You just have to get deeper. So then I started, you know, so I went from, like, the stupid surface jokes, the observational humor, all that crap, to some, you know, talking about whatever, about, you know, my feelings and insecurities. And that was funny. And then, okay, crap, you've used that up. Now what do you go to next?
And eventually, Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
But eventually, timeless. You know, you just have to keep getting deeper and deeper.
Hey, do you, maybe it's just because I'm kind of old. Does anyone remember the Bill and Ted cartoon or live-action TV show?
I have seen an episode of the live-action TV show. I was not around for it, though.
Yeah, they were not that good. It was in that period of time where they tried to take any kind of movie and... instead of remaking it, make it a TV show, because they did, like, a Back to the Future cartoon.
Ah, yes.
They did make Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure 2.
Yeah, that was
called something else. But...
Bogus Journey.
Bogus Journey, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yep.
Yeah, but that, man, they just tried to...
They just tried too hard.
Yeah, they really did. But I think George Carlin was involved in the TV show in this weird way. Where, like, you guys ever go to Universal Studios when they had the Back to the Future ride?
Yes.
It was actually Doc Brown, like,
yeah,
part of the ride. I think George Carlin showed up, like, at the beginning of an episode to be like, hey, this is the plot, or, like, what's going on? I don't know. I could be wrong. I haven't watched it since it was on TV. They were real crazy about trying to do stuff like that.
But yeah, so like, I don't know. I guess it kind of ties back to TV shows too. Humorous TV shows, eventually, where do they go?
I mean, there's certain... I think SNL, yeah, I'm going to go back to SNL quick. I feel like it's one of those shows that can last a little bit longer, but it's just like, again, they've used the same thing over and over. There's just a point where they can't do it. Certain, in comedians, back to them, where it's like, comedians who do stand-up, people like that, they have a lot of material they can work off of, because there's just always shit that happens. Whereas you can't turn that into a, like, 8-minute sketch. Like, oh, there's a guy who fell over. And you find it hilarious, and you tell people about it, but you, like, expand on it. You can't put that into a script, because people are going to be like, that's fucking stupid. Like, who cares? Like,
well,
I guess.
I mean, it works, because let's look at Family Guy.
Well, Family Guy...
Family Guy's a little bit different. It does base a lot of its stuff off of current events. It does
poke a lot
of fun at current
events.
There's
also a lot of the humor in it, though. Like, I've talked to people about this, because I see the current events humor and all that crap. But, like, I've talked to people about this, and a lot of people can't see past just the stupid humor.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
That
some
is
people
a huge,
just don't.
That is a big appeal for that show, is the stupid humor of, like, ah, Peter fought the chicken again. What?
Yeah. Well, it's just them. It's like, it's kind of like SNL. They're recycling the same thing because they think they've run out of the material and they can't put that into a 22-minute episode.
Yeah, and I guess the thing for SNL is, like, I guess at least with Family Guy, they're trying to be funny and parody themselves by repeating their same material and make fun of themselves. Like, we can't come up with anything new. SNL is just doing it.
Right, because, like, with stand-up comedians, all they need is really... because, a set probably lasts
I don't know how long a real set lasts, because I've never really seen stand-up.
Comedy specials are like an hour.
Well, but like a regular set. Like someone
depends on a feature. If it's open mic, it's like 15...
20 minutes.
Or like regular open mic, 5 minutes. If it's like a special feature where some big person shows up, they'll do like 20 minutes.
I used to my open mic sets were mostly like 5 to 10 minutes.
Sometimes I forgot you did that.
Yeah, I used to do that.
The comedic stylings of Greg Carlson.
I wasn't that funny either. That's when I started getting back into performing magic, because I was a lot funnier doing that.
Yeah.
You're really good at magic, too.
Stand-up's tough.
Stand-up is tough. I tried to do it for like a year and a half myself, and I don't think it's funny.
Nothing is worse than a dead crowd.
Yes.
It feels like someone fucking putting out a cigar in your arm.
Especially a dead crowd of people waiting to go up for their 5 minutes.
Yes. Well, at least the nice thing about that is then they're getting a dead crowd too, because everyone's just waiting to go up.
Yeah.
Well, there's certain people that are really good. A lot of comedians, I think when they first start, and this is what I've also kind of heard from other comedians, is people go up and really don't be themselves. You have to kind of be yourself, but not at the same time, if that makes any sense. Like, certain comedians,
you have to be a persona of yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, or you have to have, like, there has that side has to be there, but you're not that. So, like, people like Bo Burnham. On stage, he plays an asshole. He's not, I bet, not an asshole in real life.
Well, he might be a little bit. He could act that good.
Only a little bit.
One of the things with Bo Burnham is he's gotten to the point where he understands that regular comedy isn't as funny anymore. You can't really poke fun at other people, and you can't really poke fun at public events, and you have to poke fun at yourself. So he constantly makes fun of the fact that he comes off as really gay. And, like, good for him and all, but, like, his comedy is running real dry now. Like, he has nothing left besides, oh, people think I'm gay, ha 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 ha.
Yeah.
So it's like his newest sketch, I don't even know if that's his newest anymore. He might have come out with something new, but he's literally just questioning what people find funny now. Like, he's trying to figure out like a new
term. Last set was basically like a survey.
Basically,
funny? Please, I need this job. I can't go back to retail. They'll kill me.
I think it was like, there was one, he's like, he had an entire song goes like, what's funny, what's funny, what's funny, what's funny. I remember that one. There was an entire thing of that. It was really, I thought it was funny though.
Song kind of worked.
What's funny, funny. Not me.
Yeah, it was like this long, it was really funny. But,
what else?
It's just like every comedian when they first go up though, is just like, they go for the jugular. And it doesn't work. And then they stand there and go, why isn't this working? This is what people laugh at. It's like, people can tell when you're not doing it, like when you're not comfortable. And if you're not comfortable being in that kind of persona, then don't do it.
See,
I think my best persona is just me being a dick. Like, I don't give a shit.
That's not a persona. You're just a dick.
You're just a dick. I was going to say, that's not the difference between David and El Gordo.
Yeah.
you're both at the same time.
I'm not a bad person. I don't think I'm an awful human being.
You're not the worst.
No.
I think I'm around people. That's just the thing.
No, I have the title of the worst.
No, you don't.
Worm in the apple, Sam. Worm in the apple.
You're dead to me. Greg made... Okay, this needs some explanation for those of you...
I will gladly explain it. I stopped talking for like 6 months because
It was a while. It was a bad joke, and
it was kind of funny though. Like super messed up.
I understand it was funny, but the timing of the joke was not okay because we just finished talking about how certain jokes can be too offensive and it really affects like large crowds of people, and we shouldn't talk about these jokes. And then he drops this joke, and it was just. Really bad time.
Can I say the joke?
Yeah, you can say the joke.
So, what's the difference between the Holocaust and finding half a worm in your apple?
What?
Finding half a worm in your apple is worse because it personally affects me. stopped talking for a long time.
It was a while. I understand why people would find it funny, but just at the time, it was just... We got into an argument after he said this joke. I don't know if he was being an asshole or not.
During the argument, I was specifically trying to be an asshole at that point. I was like, yeah. I'll show you.
But yeah, it just... I was offended by just the joke in general, and we stopped talking for a while.
Yeah.
And now we're here.
Yeah.
Still awkwardly talking.
So that's why I'm not gonna be a stand-up comedian. Right there is the reason.
Because there were other shows that were kind of like SNL that just didn't last. Like, there was all that, but how far could you...
Matt TV, sorry.
Yeah, that was it.
I don't mean to keep interrupting. Yeah, all that kind of... I mean, it was like the kids' version, but they had so many repeat characters, and even when they had a new cast, they tried to rehash those characters.
Let's go to a real... Like a kids one. Let's go back to like the Amanda Show.
Oh man, that was the shit. But obviously that was only so far.
Let's go back to some like older sketch comedy stuff. Like,
you can't do that on television.
Yep. Or how about Mr. Show?
Don't remember that.
Oh, that's not a kid show.
No. I'm not talking about kid show anymore.
Oh, okay.
I'm just saying sketch comedy shows in general.
Yeah.
The typical lifespan is like 3 to 5 years. I mean, Monty Python's Flying Circus was around for like, what, 5 years?
Something like that, yeah.
Yeah, that's because it takes so much to put into an episode.
Well, with that one,
quality episode, that they get burnt out.
Even Mr. Show, though, which didn't take near as much effort, only lasted for like 3 or 4 years.
How long do you guys know the state?
I don't know.
I can't say the state. I remember that.
Oh, it had like it had Michael Showalter, Mike Lean Black, David Wayne, anyone who did Reno 911. It was an MTV show. It was really funny, but it only lasted like maybe 2 seasons, maybe just one. I don't remember.
I'm Doug, and you're Dad. Dougs and dads don't mix.
I'm Ed.
Yeah.
I don't know any of that.
Thank you.
It was a classic. I enjoyed that. Yes.
Yeah. That was
Full House.
Yeah, that was a good show. They're remaking that on Netflix.
I think we briefly talked about that too.
Really? Bob Saget. Yeah.
Once again, I don't think that was in the call though.
Yeah, we might have ended that.
That might have been in the show. So apologies if it's a repeat, but it's still a good topic. Yeah. Bob Saget, Jesse Stamos are going to be in it. Again, the Olsen twins weren't even asked back, I don't think.
Candace Cameron, or whatever.
Candace Cameron Bure, because she got married since the show.
Yeah. Dave Coulier is probably back, because I know he's not doing
it. Actually, you know what? I don't think Dave Coulier is going to be back in it, because he has a relatively successful stand-up career now.
But no, he's going to be back. Like, that was his definitive moment.
I just don't think he's going to be a big fixture in this version.
Right. Who remembers Bob Saget's old stand-up career?
Oh my god.
He was very offensive and very vulgar.
He was like Danny's evil twin from that episode, the one who was throwing all the stuff around the kitchen and making a mess. That was Bob Saget in stand-up.
Yeah, Bob Saget was
Manny Tanner.
On a lot of blow.
Yeah.
They really pegged him in Entourage.
Yeah.
Speaking of remakes, I don't know if anyone ever watched Boy Meets World. That's one of my
Girl Meets World marathon.
Yeah, Girl Meets World.
That's on Netflix.
It is on Netflix. I've yet to bring myself to watch it, but
I can't yet. I'm not sure I can.
TV shows now have a lot more restrictions than they did back in the 90s. So a lot of the stuff that they were allowed to put in TV shows back then are no longer going to be allowed, makes it harder to be.
See, my thing is, I don't think I can get into Girl Meets World, because for me, nothing can be more definitive than class dismissed. I love you all.
Yeah, like, that was a good ending.
That's it for me. Like, yeah. I'm done.
Yeah.
Talk about a solid ending to a show.
Yeah, that was fantastic.
The thing with Girl Meets World, because I might as well just talk about it, because I've seen the whole first season, I think there's a second season, there might be a third now, I have no fucking clue, but you know they're not going to get away with a lot of the stuff that they did beforehand, and they even acknowledge that, and if you're not going to, and that was the big problem with going to Disney, if you're not going to get away with this shit, there's no point in going, you know? With like there was the one about Sean dating some girl or bringing some girl sneaking into her house or something or his house because she was getting hit at home. That was a huge episode.
Quick thing.
You remember that one? That was a huge episode.
World is currently in season 2. Our starting season 2, I think. Started season 2. They're gonna have a big string of releases. Next one will be out tomorrow, actually, which will be the 18th episode of the show.
Yeah.
It's pretty much an episode a week, except they are having a big three-part thing that's going to be Girl Meets Texas, part 1, 2, and 3, October 16th.
Greg, is your microphone on the floor again?
No, it's right in front of my face. Did I get quiet?
Really?
Yeah, you got real quiet.
Yeah.
Huh.
There's just a lot of episodes that like they're not going to be able to do anymore. Like that one I just mentioned. There's a couple other ones that are really hard hitting.
Yeah.
It's going to be too childish, but.
Yeah. They got Corey and Topanga got married and they dealt with marital issues. Oh, and Corey's parents had a kid like towards the either the last or second to last season and they dealt with like. The baby might die and all this stuff.
Yeah. And we had asthma.
It was crazy. It was intense.
Yeah, that was like a three-part episode. Then there was
the cult. There was an episode where Sean wanted to join a cult.
I remember that one.
Well, he wanted to join. It was like some, you know, it was like painted as like a youth group. And Mr. Feeney was like, I know those guys. You better stay away from them. And then Mr. Turner got in a motorcycle accident, and Sean wanted to go see him, and they basically kicked the cult leader guy out of the hospital because they were like, no, you stay away from Sean. But it was crazy. It was the first time I ever really heard of a cult as a kid.
Yeah.
And then I joined one.
Wait, what?
What?
Yeah, Big Bucks is a cult.
Wait,
I hope our viewers realize that we're a cult. You're not allowed to leave.
That's actually where Liberty and Noel went. They were our sacrifices.
One of us.
Yes. Let's abandon this. Let's abandon this because someone's gonna take it seriously.
No, that was totally a joke, guys. Let's get that clear for a second.
Sam might not be joking.
Yeah, Greg's our leader, and then all of a sudden it's gonna turn into Unbreakable because I'm the dumb one here.
Unbreakable.
Kevin joined willingly. He's that one person that joined willingly.
You know, gotta keep life interesting.
Yeah, well, I feel like. Have you seen Unbreakable yet, Kevin?
The M. Night Shyamalan movie?
No, Unbreakable. The what's it? The Kimmy Schmidt story. That one.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I've seen that one.
Okay.
Just trying to think. Like, who's the Bruce Willis here? And you're not even talking about that.
Yeah, he was on a whole other topic.
Totally different.
Totally.
That's all right. No, yeah, no, okay. I know what you're talking about now, yes.
What if it's not right?
No, it's right, don't worry.
It's right, don't worry.
I mean, Netflix is getting a good amount of shows now and movies.
Yeah, they're getting all kinds of exclusives. Daredevil was amazing. I don't know if you guys watched Daredevil.
I haven't
seen it yet.
I disagree with you on that. I don't think Daredevil was a good show.
Oh, really?
Yes. I am a comic book fan myself, and a lot of Daredevil and how he works as a protagonist, I guess, wasn't accurate to how... He should have been.
Yeah, no. Daredevil's not a protagonist. No.
they made him seem like a protagonist, but in retrospect, like, he really wasn't, I guess.
No. I mean the fact that making him even seem like one, like, no.
Like, also, the way that they made his work, I guess I'll call it, like, a superpower work, was not accurate to how it actually worked. It just, I had a lot of problems with the whole, I couldn't finish the any of it because I just disagreed with how it worked, like, how the creators made him come off, I guess.
You know what I'm really looking forward to on the subject of the superhero movies? I'm really looking forward to Suicide Squad.
Me too. That seems pretty fun.
I think that should be fantastic.
I'm going to, I guess, be the minority here. I am not.
Really?
Yeah. Like, just the pictures that I've... out of the pictures I've seen, it's like... I get they're throwing Harley Quinn in there because she's part of the team in the comics now. They threw Joker in there. But just the cast photo,
Joker doesn't have his scars, and that really pisses me off.
Okay, that's fair.
Yeah. But... I could barely tell the characters apart until people were like, this is this person, this is this person. I could tell who Katana was, and I could tell who Killer Croc was, and Harley, and I knew Will Smith was going to be Deadshot. And I like the characters, but it's... I don't know. I've been very surprised by superhero movies before, so I'm definitely going to see it, but I'm just not like... You know,
you're not
going
to raise your hopes up for it.
Right. I'm more excited for Civil War, which I'm sure is probably a big mistake, but still. So I don't know. I'm not jumping out of my seat for it.
The reason I'm excited is because I honestly think that Jared Leto will make a good Joker. I could be totally wrong about that. I could be extremely wrong about that. I think there's a
I don't think Jay Leno is a good Joker at all.
He's got a point. I'm not gonna lie.
Jay Leno, no. Jared Leto, maybe.
Oh. Also, yeah.
Like, I don't know. I think he'll make a good... I think... I don't know. I think this movie would look a lot better to me if we still had Mr. Ledger on the planet.
Yeah.
Then again, though, if Mr. Ledger was still on the planet, would there ever be able to be another Joker cast again? Just kind of like, as soon as Tony Stark gets too old, can we really have more Iron Man movies?
Probably not.
Well, I think...
Like, they will be tough. Funny, but...
It'll be tough. Like,
Just based
on... Because it's kind of like video game characters or anything. Just anything, really. When they become such a staple to that character, that franchise or whatever, it's just, you can't do it. It's because everyone's going to be like, oh... I mean, probably like later on, where younger kids will be like, "Oh, that was Iron Man." But like now, if Tony Stark or whatever his name, Robert Downey Jr. leaves, they can't turn around and say, "Oh, fucking, I don't know." Throw me an actor.
Wait, hold on. Did I say when Tony Stark gets too old?
Yeah,
you might have.
Tony Holy Stark, Robert Downey crap. Jr. They both have the same life.
Yeah, they do.
Essentially, yeah. Yeah.
One thing that I am. On the topic,
actually, Tony Stark might be more successful.
No.
One thing I'm looking forward to is when they finally... this is actually going to be huge spoilers. I don't know if I should say this, actually.
Can we put a spoiler alert? Yeah, I'll put a spoiler alert.
Well, Captain America dies more than once, and he is replaced by different people. I am really excited to see if they actually follow through with killing him and... if they actually end up replacing him, and how that will affect the franchise as a whole.
I don't think that counts as a spoiler.
Superman flies around the Earth.
I just want to bring up that fact that it might be a spoiler, because a lot of the new people who are into all the... Yeah. Who don't read the comics or do any background research, they aren't aware of what's going on.
About spoiler alerts for Game of Thrones.
I think I heard rumors.
Hey, guess what? Everyone dies. Everyone you like dies.
Even everyone you hate dies, actually.
The great thing about comics is the only people who stay dead are Uncle Ben and Batman's parents.
That's fair. Actually, hold on. On the subject of dead, let's talk about this for a second.
Oh boy.
For what?
What did I open? Pandora's box did I open now?
You've opened the Pandora's box of why I hate Doctor Who.
Yes. Doctor Who lost the
Sonic
point of Doctor Who.
Sonic Screwdriver is the cheapest plot device ever.
Oh, yeah.
No, I mean, not Sonic Screwdriver. Sonic Screwdriver, yes. TARDIS, absolute cheapest plot device ever. It can even fix bad writing.
Yep. Yep.
Oh, you killed that character 3-4 seasons ago? Nah, it's cool. We really actually need him now, so you know.
Well, another thing with my biggest problem with Doctor Who is Doctor Who was originally created to get these C-class actors real life, like real chances to get back out there. And now the whole point of the show isn't to get these C-class actors out there. It's to appease the tween community.
And merchandising.
Yeah.
And
merchandising. But no, the TARDIS just pisses me off, and I always get hate for that. But no, it's the cheapest plot device ever.
Doctor Who fans.
I know, right? They're going to complain so hard in the comments, and I don't care. Let them complain. They're wrong, but let them complain. No, if you have a plot device in your show that can fix bad writing, you're doing it wrong.
Mm-hmm.
There should be no easy way to fix bad writing.
Yeah. Well, that's I agree wholeheartedly on that. But, I'd also like to point out that this has been almost an hour in this now.
I know, we're damn close. This we're 5 minutes away from an hour. And yes, yeah. Tim, Burgess Meredith always is the penguin. Always.
5 minutes remaining.
He's the only penguin ever. It's okay.
That's right. Oh, man. Not Danny DeVito?
No, Burgess Meredith.
I had Danny DeVito first, and I'm like, wait a minute. No, I got to give props where it's due. Burgess Meredith.
And that's fair. Just honestly, my favorite Jokers go in order of Heath Ledger. My second favorite Joker, I think, has to go to Cesar Romero.
Well,
batshit crazy.
Yeah. One of the things with the Jokers is they also try and have them reflect the current problems. Like, Joker reflected cocaine, then there was LSD, then there was heroin or cocaine. No, cocaine was the first one. I know the newest one's heroin. I forgot what the last one was supposed to depict. But
crocodile. Continue.
But it's I really like how they're keeping that theme up, but I still am caught up on the fact that Joker doesn't have the scars.
I'm afraid of the big black cack, Tim.
Alright, so I think, I honestly think that was a really good show.
Yeah.
I have my one final topic that I wanted to end the show with. Let's do our normal outro so I can cut off right after the final topic.
Okay. Oh wait, we still have to do the final question.
Well, the final question is kind of the final topic I have.
Oh, okay.
So I got this covered. I did a little bit of planning.
Just real quick, the topic of entertainment and stuff like that, since I am a guest, I've plugged you guys on the podcast that I'm actually a part of called VHS Bandits, so I just wanted to throw that shameless cheap plug out there.
Oh, yeah, no, of course. I was actually going to just say all of your links will be in the description, so.
Oh, sweet.
All my not links.
Griffin, you're already linked.
Damn it.
But yeah, so the normal guys, you know where to find them, youtube.com/bigboxgamers. All of Kevin's links will be in the description. I'll probably even just pop them up on the screen at random times or the video as well.
VHS Bandits.
Yeah, VHS Bandits, go check them out.
Whoa.
I'd also like to say that I'm actually going to post a video, hopefully in a week. It should be up before this, but...
I thought you said you weren't going to do that anymore.
I have been debating, but school's going a lot better than I originally thought it was going to be going, and I have a lot more free time than I originally thought I would have. So I recorded a video, and I'm just going through the editing and making an intro, and it should be up within a week.
Woohoo!
You go, Spam.
But yeah, nice. So they're all over youtube.com/bigboxgamers. Go check out VHS Bandits. Thank you very much, Kevin, for coming along.
My pleasure.
Crazy ride.
Thanks for having me.
It was his pleasure.
Yes, and normally I would say you can go find Gordo over at his channel with a link in the description, but let's tie into the final topic.
Oh.
We will see, depending on his answer. You might be able to find Gordo's links over in the side panel at youtube.com/bigboxgamers because this is your official invitation.
Oh. I would love to join this.
And there we go. So yeah, you can find him at youtube.com/bigboxgamers as well.
No,
congrats,
I mean,
Gordo.
Yay.
Yeah. So can we kick out I just say can we do a quick vote out of the tribe here? Can we vote out Griffin?
No.
Wait. No.
It depends on how much you bribe me. See you guys next time.
Shots fired.